Hello, I am Dr. K. K. Mishra. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel, R Classes. In my efforts of dealing with questions that may trap you in job interviews, today another important question I am going to discuss. The question is, could you have done better in your last job? Now, if you analyze it, if you look at it, so this is another question that poses, that opens a big trap for you that you may enter into, because it is indicating that you can reveal your some greatest flaws in your past performances of your experience. So if you are unprepared, if you are not proactive, you can be really caught in the trap. Let us see how to go about it. A hiring manager asking, could you have done better in your last job, may seem like a tricky proposition where he or she is trying to get you to admit some major flaw, as earlier I indicated it to you. No one is perfect, yes, it goes without saying. But a job interview is not the place to confess to all your shortcomings. Let me tell you, viewers, that you need not to be that honest that you start in at a place, at a time where you are being interviewed, you are facing an interview. You should not be publicly accepting all your shortcomings. Then what's the way out? Let us see here. Being self-critical is important. And a prospective employer wants to know whether you are capable of looking at your performance and finding areas of improvement on your own. The most important thing to remember for questions like this is to never cast yourself in a negative light. Defining how your old skills and strengths can be used in your new career inside your resume in a proper way, with a specific format that is also appropriate for that new career, is imperative. As I was telling about the trap, this is no time for true confessions of major or even minor problems. One should avoid it. There is a trap. It is important to remind the interviewer that you have these skills and experiences needed to excel in this new position, even if there are ways you can improve upon yourself. There are certain points that you must emphasize on while answering or preparing the answer to such questions in interviews. 1. Mention how a bad experience at a previous job was beyond your control. Talk about overcoming obstacles. Give the impression that you are sincerely thinking about the question. Use this question as a segue to talk about your accomplishments. Question that asks you to discuss the negative attributes about yourself should really be viewed to promote yourself and talk about your positive attributes. Here is a catchy point, that even if you start speaking, you speak in such a way that it appears that you are talking about your positive attributes. Now, there are certain points which you must avoid. Like, too many people are unprepared to answer this question and end up actually talking about their really downfalls, actual ones. Avoid falling for this mistake and be prepared. There are points to be kept in mind. First, don't go into major problems or issues you had with your last job. Don't be so honest, revealing your personal problems are the actual ones, because then they may start, you know, facing, you may start facing another tough questions that may question your overall personality. Another point, don't simply say no and move on. That makes you avoiding the situation or the question. Don't describe an incident that led to a major consequences. It is just like that you are inviting the problem. Don't do like that. Be careful not to get too nervous. Yes. Why to be nervous? This is not the last job interview. The world is full of, you know, opportunities. Umpteenth opportunities are available in your surrounding. Don't worry. Not that you are going to lose something. So keeping these points which you should avoid, everyone has made mistakes, let me tell you. Nobody is perfect. And I personally am of the opinion that being perfectionist is one of the disqualifications of a person. But at the same time, I must know my mistakes so that I can improve upon. So everyone has made mistakes, but an interview for a new job should be an opportunity for you to discuss all the ways you will benefit this new organization. So ideally, though you should take this opportunity to talk about education, use the same tactics as described in the previous article or video tutorial, but rather than talk about college, mention the classes the company offered or the classes you noticed were available when not in the office. There are answers. Say, let us have a look at what could be a bad answer to this question, or what could be a good answer or a simple answer, so that you can draw more out of it to prepare your own answer to this question. Bad answer: I wish I did not work there in the first place. It was not a pleasant environment. I also wish I did not try to flirt with my boss. When their partner found out, we were in a lot of trouble. This could be something which is really bad. Now, what could be a good answer? I wish I had taken advantage of some of the classes and conferences the company offered to pay for. At the time, I wanted to keep my focus on the work, but I feel like I missed out on several potential learning opportunities. This is something, a good one. Now, what could be a better answer? This question actually can stem a lot of applicants, but a good response will be something along the lines of, like here, honestly, in retrospect, there was probably something I could have done better at my last job, but nothing of any major consequence really comes to mind. We had a few setbacks as a result of the recent economic downturn, but ultimately, that just taught us to be better prepared for anything. So, it is the interviewer's job to learn as much about you as possible, and a lot can be learned from your personality if you actually delve into all the problems you encountered at your last job. These types of negative questions are common in interviews, but the best way to approach them is to view them as an opportunity to sell yourself further to this new empire. So this was all about that question. I believe that you have definitely liked it. My upcoming video tutorial could be on, can you work under pressure? More video tutorials on management subjects, interview questions, and developing personality and soft skills are available on my YouTube channel, R Classes. I expect that definitely you have liked it. And if you have liked it, so please don't forget to subscribe my channel, R Classes, and press the bell button and pass it on to others, those who are needy now and in the future. Thank you. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you very much. Have a nice time. Best of luck.